Hello everyone, welcome to the 2020 SGP Annual Research Update Series. My name is Jingjing Zong. This video will present a walkaway VSP survey for fractured basement imaging using random space shift reverse time migration. My co-authors are Dr. Jizhong, Dr. Arthur Cheng, and Dr. Yunyue, Elita. On this video, we will start with an introduction to the survey area and acquisition geometry. Next, the numerical wave field simulation will be shown to serve as an analog to understand the P and S wave field information. We will then talk about the VSP pre-processing. Following that, we will see the P-wave image by RSS-RTM and draw some conclusions on the current work. Finally, we will share with you two lines of our ongoing work following the current results. Let's first revisit the vertical seismic profile survey geometry. VSP surveys employ surface sources and borehole receivers and record high-quality multi-component wave field data. The receivers are often three-component geophones and are clamped onto the wellbore while recording. Recently, optic fibers become the cheaper alternatives and have a considerable potential for permanent monitoring. The sources can be either dynamite or viral track. The dynamite generates an impulsive source signature, while the viral track generates a sweep of vibration at varying frequencies. The VSP surveys are used to obtain rock properties and seismic images in the neighborhood of the wellbore. With the presence of subsurface reflectors, the main event a receiver would record include the downgoing direct arrivals, the downgoing multiples, the upgoing primary reflections, and the upgoing multiples. An example of the crowding shot gathered on the receiver side is plotted with the horizontal axis at the increasing depth to the right, the vertical axis at the increasing time to the bottom. It displays a Z-component shot gather recorded by the geophone. On the other hand, the depth recording, which is a single direction along the borehole, shows the similar features, but somewhat different amplitude, noise level, frequency content, etc. Due to the special source and receiver arrangement, the VSP reflection coverage is quite different from the surface seismic. The VSP survey gives a cone-shaped illumination range as shown in the white area. Put aside with the surface seismic image, it is evident that within the narrow illumination area, the VSP image provides a higher signal-to-noise ratio data with higher resolution and more details. It is mainly because in the VSP survey, the reflections are picked up on the downhole receiver locations with a shortened wave path compared to that with the surface seismic. At the same time, by avoiding traveling through the shallow weathering layers, the VSP reflections have a higher resolution seismic recording. And thus, we expect the VSP image to serve as an enhancement on top of the surface seismic image in local areas that finer images are required. The study area is located at a depression where highly productive reservoirs were found around and beneath fracture basement. In the map, the red areas are the developing reservoirs. The fractured basement reservoir poses great challenges to seismic exploration, as they are associated with complex fault and fracture networks, strong heterogeneity, and distinguished seismic impedance contrast between the basement rocks and the surrounding sedimentary rocks. In 2017, two walkaway VSPs were acquired at well locations A and B to provide higher resolution images and to better delineate the highly faulted dipping structures. A surface seismic survey was carried out at the first place and illuminated the general structures and dipping features. The walkaway VSPs were acquired using a combination of dynamite and vibrosized sources. The three-component geophone records signals in the downhole locations with interval of 20 meters. Well A penetrates less than 2 kilometers, while well B went deeper and penetrates through the basement top. In this video, we present the survey carried out at well B to show the dipping features. At well B, There are a total of 267 shot locations, with an interval of 25 meters on average. The geophones recorded 6 seconds data at a total of 126 levels from 500 to 3000 meters. We first run the numerical simulations to understand the elastic wave field. Based on the geologic model interpreted from the early surface seismic image, as well as the velocity and density surveys, a simplified model was built to feature the general structure. We run elastic wave field modeling using spectrum element method. Examples of near offset shots are shown along with the actual field shot gathers. At well A, the simulated near offset shot gathered has the main reflectors match very well with the field records. The blue arrows mark the P wave reflections, while the red arrows mark the converted shear wave reflections at the top of basement. The main differences between the simulated and the field records is the tube wave, which comes after the direct arrivals at a slower velocity, it was not simulated, and it will be removed as a noise in the field record before imaging. The similarly good coherence between the simulated and field records repeats for well B, near offset shots. It indicates that we have a reasonable initial velocity model to start with. It is noticeable that the converted wave at the top of basement is strong, even at the near offset shots. As the acoustic RTM saves computation cost and employs a more straightforward imaging condition, it will be used in this study. However, it requires the separated P and S wave field. With the observation of the strong shear wave conversions, we are reminded of the importance of the proper wave field separation in this study. Next, we'll get into the data preparation with an emphasis on the wave field separation. Let's first look at the three-component raw shot gathers that we're about to process. Downgoing P and S and upgoing P and S, as well as the tube waves, are highlighted. The task of the preprocessing is to separate P and S in their upgoing and downgoing fields, and suppress noises such as the tube waves, multiples, etc. We follow a classic VSP preprocessing flow to prepare the data, with a careful touch on the P and S wave field separation. After the initial data preparation, including loading, autocorrelation, stacking, we set up the source receiver geometry. We sorted the data by the common shot gather and went through the trace editing to get rid of the anomalies. The P wave first arrivals were picked at the Z component mostly and transferred to other channels for later hologram analysis and wave field alignment. We redistributed the primary downgoing P and S wave energy using the two-step hologram rotations. After that, the medium filters were applied to separate the downgoing and the residual fields. The downgoing wave field was then used to test the deconvolution parameters that will be applied to the upgoing wave fields. The near-offset downgoing fields were often used to obtain 1D velocity profile and Q factors. On the other hand, upgoing wave fields were further subjected to time-variant rotation to obtain the finally separated P and S wave fields. Other enhancements, including FK filters, bandpass filters, can be applied to remove some more noises. With a smooth velocity model, the separated P and S wave fields after deconvolution will be imaged using RSS-RTM. Let's look at an example of a separated P and S wave field. Starting with the raw shot gathers, most energies are distributed in Z and X. Clear P and S reflections are seen on the top of the basement. At the first rotation between X and Y component, the downgoing P wave energy was maximized in Hmax channel and minimized in the Hminimum channel. The second rotation between Hmax and Z channels further redistributed the max downgoing P wave energy into a direct channel and the residuals into a radio channel. In this displayed shot, most downgoing P wave and upgoing shear wave are redistributed to direct channel after the vertical rotation, and the radio channel contains more upgoing P wave energy. A 13-point medium filter was then applied to separate the downgoing P waves. The reflections in this study are largely remained in the upgoing field. Thus, we separated and enhanced P and S wave reflections from the upgoing field. The retracing-based time-variant rotation further redistributed the upgoing P wave into one channel and the residuals into another. the P and S wave reflections are gradually separated into two channels. Finally, we applied FK filters and bandpass filters to enhance the upgoing wave field and the deconvolution to improve the resolution and to suppress the multipoles. During acquisition, the worker one line has some minor deviations and discontinuities in the areas with local infrastructures, while the borehole is slightly deviated at the bottom. Since the acquisition system still largely remains as a 2D system, we simplify the issue by projecting both shot and receiver arrays onto a 2D plan. We next implemented RSS-RTM to the field data. We used a smooth velocity model used in the surface seismic for fair comparison. The VSP image was bordered in red and incorporated in the surface seismic image. It is obvious that the VSP image provides a higher resolution and a pronounced amount of details in its illumination range. To evaluate the value of the pre-processing effort, we also imaged the raw Z component. The image from the raw Z component is showing on the left. After wave field separations, a considerable amount of the noise has been reduced and more complete and coherent structures have been revealed by careful pre-processing, as we can see from the comparison. The downgoing wave field and the shear wave removal contribute to a lower noise level in general. The redistributed P wave energy from all three components give rise to a more detailed and complete P image. On the other hand, although the conventional RTM has been increasingly used for VSP surveys and demonstrate the capability to deliver high fidelity images while utilizing all seismic wave field types and not imposing limitations on velocity variations and reflector dip, it is very sensitive to velocity errors. A direct implementation of RTM to the field data may result in defocused migration image due to the uncertainties in the velocity model. RSS-RTM partially mitigate this problem by stacking the extended migration image along the subsurface offset axis within a half-wavelength constraint. The special shift at each time step is randomly assigned in order to reduce the computation cost. We implemented both conventional RTM and RSS-RTM. It is obvious that the RSS-RTM image appears to be more continuous and the migration smiles are effectively reduced. Combining the efforts of both careful wave field separations and the RSS-RTM, we hope to provide a better subsurface image for interpretation. To conclude, we have applied careful preprocessing and RSS-RTM to a work-away VSP survey acquired around a fractured basement reservoir. It is verified that a proper wave field separation utilizing 3C information lays a foundation to improve the image quality. A more clear and complete P wave field after separation gives rise to a better P image with reduced noise level and enriched details. For field applications where the accurate velocity models are not necessarily available, RSS-RTM demonstrates the reliability of producing a good image. Set side by side with the surface seismic post-active migration, the VSP RSS-RTM image provides higher resolution and more details in its illumination range, which encourages better characterization of the fractured basement. Following the P-wave imaging success, we're working on two extended directions. First, on the comparison with the dust data. As the fiber optics record one component data as opposed to the three component geophone data, two questions are asked. One, how does the dust data compare with the raw Z geophone data? And two, what's the significance of the wave field separation in the dust data? And how do we handle it if a separation is needed? On the other hand, we're working on getting a shear wave image. As shown earlier, we have separated P and S reflections for imaging. The examples showed that the separated shear gathers are in good quality. The next challenge we have is to solve the shear wave velocity model building. Now, this is the end of this video. Please share your comments and suggestions by sending me an email. Thank you for watching.